Thank you for downloading our free Liquid Inventory spreadsheet. In this video, we're going to show you how to set up your computer so that the tool will work correctly. And then we're going to show you how to use the tool, meaning you'll have a faster and more effective way to take Liquid Inventory at your bar. So the first task to complete is to install a bar.i folder onto your C drive. You need to open Windows Explorer. You can see I have a shortcut down at the bottom. You can also press the Windows plus the E key at the same time. You'll need to select Computer and then C drive. You can see I've already installed this bar.i folder, but for you to do the same, you need to right click, select new, and then folder, and then fill in the name exactly as I have here. That will enable the auto save feature of the spreadsheet to work correctly. The second task you need to complete is to enable macros in Excel. So go ahead and open up your version of Microsoft Excel. We're working here in 2010 version, but if you look below this video on our site, you'll see links to show you how to do this if you're using 2003 or 2007 versions. In 2010, click on the File menu, click Options on the left, Trust Center in the box which pops up, and then the Trust Center button. Make sure we have macro settings selected on the left, and on these radio buttons, we need to have this bottom one selected, enable all macros. Click OK twice and you're completed, and then you'll need to reopen Excel in order for those settings to become active. Now we're going to show you how to actually use the Liquid Inventory spreadsheet. We suggest that you copy the file that you downloaded into your bar.i folder we created in the last step. Then double click on the inventory spreadsheet to open it up. First of all, you'll see along the bottom, we've got a number of tabs that each have a different purpose. You don't actually need to do anything on this previous count tab, as when you save the tool, it will automatically load the information you counted previously and load it into the previous count for this time. But it's important you know where this is. It will help with error checking if you get unexpected results, so you can compare counts 1 week to the counts the previous week. Moving on to the product info tab, this is where we enter our product list and also the pricing information. If you're transferring over from a previous Excel spreadsheet, you can actually paste product names right into this array here, or you can fill it in by hand as I'm doing. So I filled in Coors bottle, goes into the bottle beer category, and the price is $19 per case of 24. Keeping with that Colorado theme, we've got Keg Coors Light draft beer for $65. Obviously that is a different amount, so we've selected single from the drop down. Well Vodka belongs to the liquor category. We've got the price at $6 per bottle. We have House White Wine. We could enter either the bottle or the case price, but make sure that we match, so we are $60 per case here. I'm going to enter perhaps one other item, let's say Grenadine. Belongs to the miscellaneous category. Stuff is pretty cheap, so let's say $5, and that would be the price for a single bottle. So the next sheet is the count worksheet. That's where we actually enter the counts for what's physically in store. The nice thing is the product information here is automatically loaded. Each time you save the tool, it'll be sorted, so it's in alphabetical order by category. And one thing you'll need to do to start is to fill in the zone names. We fill this in for illustrative purposes. We recommend using all 10 of those zones to break up the areas where you count, because one of the differences between doing this and a clipboard is it makes it more granular and it's easier to do your counts and it's easier to check back and find errors. Let's enter some counts for Grenadine. Perhaps we have a half bottle in the well, and then here in dry storage we've got the rest of the case. Again, you can see that the amounts and value on hand automatically update. After we finished our counts, the next piece of information to fill in is deliveries for the period and also sales. For the deliveries, we'll typically pull that out of your accounting software. I'm going to say we had $300 worth of wine deliveries in the period, and then from our point of sale, we have $950 in wine sales. You can see the amounts for deliveries and sales automatically update at the bottom, and they'll also be pulled through onto this liquor cost worksheet, where our total liquor cost is shown here. The very first time you use this, you need to fill in the date for the day you're doing this on, say the 9th of September. And that's important for the autosave feature, which I'm going to show you now. Moving on to the final liquor cost trend worksheet. This is where we're going to summarize our performance over time and try and build up a better picture of how your liquor cost is evolving. So once you've completed the inventory, you've double-checked your counts and numbers, and this figure here seems plausible, then we're ready to go ahead and finalize the count. How we're going to do that is just to run the autosave feature by pressing the Control and the L buttons at the same time. When you do that, a number of things are going to happen. It will automatically save the file as, save a new version using today's date. You can see it's added the liquor cost from the cycle we just completed onto our trend graphs here. And then it's asking us to tell it the ending date for the next time we're going to be taking inventory. That's going to be in the future. So that'll be the first of the next month if you do monthly. Or I'm imagining we're doing weekly inventory here. You can type in the next date. Press OK. And that auto load feature will complete. You see the counts have been cleared out and transferred to the previous count. Product information will have been sorted alphabetically, so that the new products you added on the bottom will fall correctly into order. Deliveries and sales has been blanked, as has liquor cost. And then when we complete it next time, we'll see the current liquor cost added onto this graph, so you can track that trend. So this is our free tool. If you like this one, we'd recommend you check out the paid services. In addition to saving you time, that's going to help you reduce your liquor cost by more than 3% on average. Basically, you just count everything fast, let us take care of the number crunching and data entry, allowing you to get on with your day and manage your bar more closely. Thanks for watching, and don't be afraid to send us an email or drop us a line if you have any questions or you'd like to see us develop any other tools.